Hi, welcome to the channel. Today, I'm going to share a SQL INSERT Statement. Let's get started. So, what is SQL INSERT Statement? INSERT Statement is used when you want to add data to a table. It allows you to add single or multiple rows of data to the table. To get us started, we're going to use this employee table. It has 7 columns or fields. Employee ID is defined as integer. And salary is defined as decimal with 2 decimal places. The rest are varchar or string for some. Now, this employee table is still empty. There is no record. As you can see, there's no record yet. And now I'm going to share 3 different ways to write an insert statement. The first one is we're going to insert by specifying the column and the values. This is the syntax. You have the keyword insert into and the table that you want to use and the columns that you desire. And you specify here the corresponding values as well. Okay, now we're going to add a new employee. So let's put this as a comment and we're going to do the actual insert. Insert into table name is employee, and we're going to put the columns. We have employee ID, we have first name, last name, job title, salary, city, and state. Let me adjust that so we can see it better. There you go. And the values. For the values here, we need to align the corresponding values according to the column flow or the column order. So the first value we'll have is 1, first record. Since it is integer, then our first employee is Neo Anderson. State of New York. Okay. Now we can run this. So when we execute this, we are expected to add this new employee. There you go. As you can see, it says here one row affected. And let's validate that. So if we're going to run this, we should have 1. There you go. And if we want to see the actual record, rows, run this, there you go. We just have added employee ID number 1, first name Neo, last name Anderson. Now, as I mentioned, we specify the columns here manually. It means that it gives us flexibility on how we order them or what columns we just need. And there's corresponding values. If you notice, our table was defined as auto increment. It means that we're going to allow the database to assign the employee ID. That's why this option is suitable in our needs. Let's put this, let's comment it out. We're going to create an insert. Insert into employee. And we are just showing that first name. We start with first name because the employee ID will be assigned automatically. Last name, job title, salary, city, and state values. So we just follow the values. So we will start with the first name. Our second employee is Anakin Skywalker, and he is our structural engineer. And salary of 123,050. He's from Anchorage, state of Alaska. There you go. So let's add him. Third, there you go. One is affected. We successfully added Anakin. So if we're going to validate, how many employees do we have? 2. We have 2 now. And if we run this, there you go. So we have Anakin. He has been added successfully. And if you see, the employee ID has been generated. So the focus here is, the intent is not on auto increment, but more on you have this insert gives you the flexibility of including only those columns that you need. The second option is to insert by specifying only the values. It is a shorthand version of the first option, just without the flexibility on the column selection, because this option will choose all the columns by default. So it means that your values that you're going to specify here needs to follow the order of the column that you define in the table. Let me show you. So here, let's put that into a comment. And if we create our own insert into a employee table and values, and we put here our third employee. Employee number 3, we hire Obi-Wan as our junior executive. So if you notice, we have followed the order the way our columns has been defined in the table. There you go. One row means that, look here, means that we successfully insert or added a new record. So if we were going to validate that, if we run this again, there you go. We have added Obi-Wan. Okay, now, for the third option, we're going to do an insert using a subquery. This is an advanced option. It can be used similar to the first option, where you specify all the columns. Then subquery will provide the values. So here, you specify all the columns here. And the subquery will provide these values, the corresponding values. Now, this option can also be like the second option, only that the subquery will provide the corresponding values. So here, we expected that we're going to include all the columns and the insert. And here, you can do the same. You match it. Asterisk will going to carry all the column. Either asterisk or you define the column one by one. And the advantage of this is a multi-row process. It means that it can process one row to thousands of rows to millions of rows or more. It really depends on the volume of the data that you're processing. Let me show you. But first, take note of this. We have two tables here. From here, the target table. And here in the subquery, the source table. So to do this, I have created another table, which is just a copy of employee table. I call it employee record. If we're going to check employee record, it has the same number of columns with the employee table. And currently, we don't have any record or any rows in this employee record table. So let's use that insert with subquery. Comment this out. We're going to create insert into target table, which is the employee record, and the corresponding columns. Employee ID, first name, last name, job title, salary, city, and state. Then, the subquery, select. Let's adjust the size so you can see that. Select, and the employee ID, or you can just copy them here. From here, copy them from employee table. There you go. So, let's run this. And there you go. It says 3 rows affected. So let's check that here. If we run this employee record, there you go. We have a copy of the 3 records coming from employee table. So if you look at the employee table right now, you have 3. And just copy it over to employee record. And as I mentioned, the second way is similar to the option 2, wherein you have the table name and you expect all the columns to be included, or it is expected that all the columns are going to be in use. So your subquery will have all the corresponding columns here. Now let's try that. Deleted the data here so we can demonstrate the second one. So there we go. We don't have any data here. Comment this out, and we'll do have an insert and 2 employee record. Then you do the select. So since we are going to include all the columns here, we can do the same in select, right? Just use asterisk. In just this insert alone, you can copy all the rows from this table and to this table, regardless of the volume. So let's run that. There you go. So let's verify. Let's validate. There you go. You have copied the employee table as well. You have copied these rows and two. This table. You can do more a lot on this, but we're going to cover that in the future. traffic. So that's all for the insert for now, and I hope you learned something. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.